that our seas and oceans are vital for India's growth and prosperity. He considers the Indian Navy to be a force for peace and good. He has also expressed the belief that international cooperation and collective action in the maritime domain will advance economic activity and peace for the benefit of the entire humanity. It is in this context that a strong and capable Navy becomes important for India. Having witnessed firsthand the progress of the Western fleet today, I must admit that the Indian Navy is fully capable of exercising this power in times of war with even more lethality. I take this opportunity to express the nation's gratitude for the constant vision that you maintain at sea. As a result, maritime interests are safe and secure. It is because of the tireless efforts of each one of you that the operational footprint of the Indian Navy is widespread and duly respected everywhere in the world. Our ships then deployed on anti-piracy patrols in the Gulf of Aden have not only enabled safe passage for thousands of merchant ships, but have displayed the enduring efficiency of your capabilities. Our mission-based deployments in the Indian Ocean region have effectively contributed in keeping the seas safe and allowed us to act as first responders in a crisis. The high-level preparedness maintained by the Indian Navy has been pivotal in the humanitarian assistance and also in disaster relief. Such operations which have enabled timely assistance to bring succor to during natural disasters, both in India and on foreign shores. The recent operation command by the Navy in the wake of the cyclone Oki helped save about 845 lives. These lives and the many more that you have saved over the years stand testimony to your resolve as a force for good. You are all aware that the maritime security environment around our country is fast evolving. I am happy that the Indian Navy has continuously adopted and evolved to remain a potent and capable force. I am confident that your presence and preparedness will deter our adversaries from attempting any action detrimental to our sovereignty and safeguard our interests. Our government is sparing no efforts to enable and empower the armed forces as they stand firm on our borders. A number of measures have already been implemented and others are being fast-tracked as we seek to equip our armed forces. I firmly believe that indigenous capability is key to strategic authority. Authority, liberalization of licensing regime, raising the cap on FDA, that's foreign direct investments in the agribusiness sector, and guidelines for strategic partnership have been put in place to give impetus to Make in India initiative. The commissioning of a number of platforms within the last 1 year, including supplemental money, all of them indigenously built, demonstrates our commitment to bring the Navy's capability enhancement to fruition and encourage indigenous shipbuilding. To adequately support the growth of our seagoing assets, there has been a focused trust in terms of development of the infrastructure reform as to the infrastructure at home. These, along with rapid progress in our strategic projects, are helping shape the future of our Navy in a structured manner. The government views Navy as its principal instrument to discharge its role as a national security provider in our areas of maritime interest and is committed to its role. I urge all personnel of the Indian Navy to devote themselves to their duties with full confidence in their platforms, machinery, weapons, and sensors. I assure you that you will get the best and adequate numbers. Over the last 24 hours, the Western Fleet has demonstrated its combat potential. I have watched your professionalism, visited the respective places where you work, and have had the privilege of interacting with many of you. Let me say that I am indeed truly impressed. I believe that it is on the shoulders of our men and women in uniform that the nation places the weight of its safety, security, and sovereignty. I would like to remember that you are the first respondents to defend our interests beyond our borders. Personally, for me, this visit and the privacy has been a very educative experience. I confident all of you on your